Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will discuss about the Java programming and programming language. And in my previous videos or playlist, we are discussing about important questions of Java theory. But this series is practical, and we will discuss or learn programming here or practically. So let's start. Java is an object-oriented programming language. There are three terms: encapsulation, abstraction, polymorphism, which will we study in between our programming. Why learn Java? Java is a platform independent. It typically means some combination of hardware and system software, but there you can understand it's an operating system. Java is compiled to an intermediate form of Java bytecode, or simply bytecode. A Java program never really executes immediately after compilation on the host machine. Rather than this special program called the Java interpreter or Java virtual machine reads the bytecode and translate it into the corresponding host machine instruction and then execute the machine instruction. A Java program can run on any computer for which JVM and some library routines have been installed. So the second important part which makes Java portable is the elimination of hardware architecture depends constructs. So next is object oriented. So the first data and the second is methods. Data is instance variable and the second is method. So data and method are closely related to the real world structure and behavior of object. Object oriented programming has number of advantages like simpler to read program, efficient reuse of programming segment, robust error free code. So most of the object oriented concepts in Java are inherited from the C++, which make it easy for traditional programmer to understand it. And third quality is easy to learn. Java is easy to learn for programmer because it is a syntax similar to C and C++. Most of the complex parts of C and C++ have been excluded in as operator overloading, multiple inheritance and pointers. Approximately half of the bugs in C or C++ program are related to memory location and delocation. Therefore, the important addition in Java is automatic memory location or delocation. And fourth point is robust. Java provides checking of possible problems at two levels, one at the compile time and other at the runtime. So the program are highly reliable and elimination situations that are error prone compared to C++. So, but many time pointers are the main cause of runtime error because improper use of memory. Java eliminates pointer manipulation completely from the language and therefore eliminate a large source of runtime error. Java programmer need not remember to deallocate memory in program since there is a garbage collection mechanism which handles deallocation of memory. It provides powerful, a robust exception handling mechanism to deal with both expected and unexpected errors at runtime. And next is secure. Java is intended to work in networked and distributed environment by providing security. Each Java applet can be executed in runtime environment that restricts them introducing viruses, deleting, modifying file in host computer. Java is strongly typed language, which means that variables should be declared and variables should not change types. Typecasting is strictly limited, highly sensible, and therefore you can cast an int to a long, or you can cast byte to a short, but you cannot cast at an int to a boolean or int to a string. The major security issue in the world is bugs. Unintended bugs are responsible for more data loss than data loss because of viruses. In Java, it is easier to write bug-free code than in other languages. Multi-threaded. Before answering what is multi, let me explain that what the thread is. Simply, a thread is a simple path of execution. So the best solution to this program is execution of two or more sections of program at the same time. This technique is known as multi-threading. Multi-threaded application deliver their potent power by running many threads concurrently within a single program. So ability of an individual program to do more than one thing at the same time is most efficiently implemented through threads. Java is inherently multi-threaded. For example, garbage collection subsystem runs as a low priority thread. A single Java program can have many different threads executed independently continuously. For example, different Java applets on the same web page can run together with getting equal time for processor. Because multi-threaded applications share data All threads of application exist in the same data space. Therefore, to maintaining reliability is sometimes difficult, to making easy the use of threads. Java offers features for synchronization between threads. Dynamic. Java was designed to adapt to an evolving environment. Therefore, the Java compiler is smart and dynamic. If you are compiling a file that depends on other non-compiled files, then the compiler will try to find the compiled demos. For example, web browser can load applets of other classes without recompilation. High performance. Java is a fast interpreted language. Java has also been designed to so that the runtime system can optimize their performance by compiling bytecode to native machine code on fly execute immediately after compilation. This is called just-in-time compilation. Java offers two flavors of programming, Java applet and Java application. Applets are small Java program that can download it over computer network and run from web page by using Java enabled browser like Netscape, Microsoft Internet Explorer. Applets are used to add dynamic features like animation, sound, etc. to web pages. So that's all the qualities of Java. Why learn Java? A first simple program is here. Public class main, public static void main string args, and system.out println. While looking at the program, we have to explain all the terms in this program. Whenever you write a program, these terms you have to familiar with this program, these terms. So here is system.out println is used for printing something like this. Here is a system.println is for in inverted commas is a hello world. For printing hello world, so this term is used. Public means key, these are the keywords, and public class, public means the access to outside the class also allowed. Or here is main, or the program starts from here. So let's see the one program here. Basically, I started programming in NetBeans, and for a small program I want to show you on this compiler. If you want to know how to get this compiler, just type here online Java compiler and you will get it. So I have typed here online Java compiler, and this is here, and some code is already written here. So if we want to run this code, so how can we do it? Let's see. Run. So here is the output, hello world, and this is a debug, and here we can stop the program, or we can share the code, or save or verify it. So let's change this code and write something else, like we want to type this is my first program. Let's see what is the output here. This is my first program. Whatever you write here, and you will get the output, same output here. Okay. So basically we use the framework like NetBeans. If you want to start the first program, or after doing 3 to 4 programs on the online compiler, you can start from NetBeans framework. It's easy. Or in industry now Spring is very famous, so you can start with the after doing on NetBeans, you can start with Spring or directly with Spring also. With Java, you can make a full application in the same with the same one language with Java, or you can use in front end React.js or JavaScript, and in the back end Java. It depends on you. So it's our first program. So let's start. Let's do something else also. Some other program. Here is another short class. Main is. Let's change the class here. Or same classes also. Okay. So let's see public static, and we have to change here, right here. Take a variable int num and value num. This is num. The value of num is, let's see here, value of num and system dot print ln. Here is we better to print num. Num. So let's see the output. This is num is 100 and this value is num into 2 is and num is. So something wrong here. Whoa. Oh. So this is a correct output. So you can practice as many as question as you can.